JC.
Alana.
Kevin.
Rona.
Josh.
My Lynn.
Blaine.
Terry.
Fred. And you.
Welcome to the Mickey Mouse Club.
It's Monday, Music Day, and we've got a lot of music for you, including our special Music Day guest, C.C. Peniston.
Plus, we'll go on the road with MMC and check out another music video in our UBS Star contest, plus a lot more.
Well, you're not going to tell us what it is? Well, you got to watch.
Okay, we'll have to watch. Well, coming up right now, we're going to start things off right with a song from our MMC Rocks the Planet concert. Here's Matt and Tony singing Wholehearted. Yeah.
Life's ambition occupied my time. Priorities confuse the mind. Happiness one step behind. This inner peace I've yet to find. Rivers flow into the sea. Yet even the sea's not so full of me. If I'm not blind, why can't I see?
This circle can't be where a square should be. There's a hole in my heart that can only be filled by you. And this hole in my heart can't be filled with the things I do. Wholehearted. Wholehearted.
Oh, come on, yeah. This heart of stone is where I hide. These feet of clay kept warm inside. Day by day, the saddest fire. And I fade away before I die.
River flowing to the sea. Yet even the sea's not so full of me. If I'm not blind, why can't I see?
That a circle can't fit where a square should be.
There's a hole in my heart that can only be filled by you. And this hole in my heart can't be filled with the things I do. There's a hole in my heart that can only be filled by you. I should have known from the start I fall short with the things I do. Wholehearted, wholehearted.
Continuing drama as the law turns.
Now, on an uneven exchange, give the customer a receipt and send them to the returns department on 6.
What's a receipt?
You better get your act together, Moody Botnick. Don't expect to ride on my coattails just because you're my less attractive, less intelligent little sister.
You're always criticizing me, Bayonne. Ever since I developed that split personality, Raven.
Raven was my split personality. Your split personality is Desiree. Listen, ladies better swimwear may be your last chance. You're at Buford's.
I know!
You're lucky Artie Buford didn't fire you last week. He doesn't appreciate his perfume spritz girls rolling around on the main floor sneezing hysterically.
That was not my fault. Ever since I was kidnapped by that evil cosmetologist Enid Delvecchio, I've been allergic to perfume.
Well, just don't forget that R.G. Buford's spoiled, eccentric son, Beau Buford, is our department manager.
Beau Buford?
Yes, well, he's filthy rich, and his millions are soon to be mine.
Here he comes.
Hello, Bayonne. Ring-a-ding-ding. Who have we here?
This is nobody, just my kid sister Moody, who was left on our doorstep under very mysterious circumstances.
Well, hello, Moody. What do you say we go grab a bite at Connie's corn dog?
I'm warning you, Moody. He's bad news. I should know. I'm bad news, too. I can't help it, Bayonne. I've fallen for him, and I can't get up.
As the Maw returns, we'll continue.
You.
Mm-hmm.
Star.
Okay, JC, we have a terrific winner in this week's You Be a Star music video contest.
Here from the beautiful mountains of Morrilton, Arkansas, singing Achy Breaky Heart, Bryce Harris.
You can tell the world you never was my girl. You can burn my clothes when I'm gone. Or you can tell your friends what a fool I've been and laugh and joke about me on the phone. You can tell my aunt go back onto the farm. You can tell my feet hit the floor. Or you can tell my lips, tell my fingertips, they won't be reaching out for you no more. But don't sell my heart, my achy, breaky heart. I just don't think you'd understand. And if you sell my heart, my achy, breaky heart, he might rob and kill this man. You can tell your mom I moved to Arkansas. You can tell your doctor by my leg. Or tell your brother Cliff this can cure my lip. He never really liked me anyway. Or tell Eloise, tell anything you please. A separated nose, not okay. Or you can tell my eyes, watch out for my mind. It might be walking out on me today. But don't tell my heart, my achy, breaky heart. I just don't think you'd understand. And if you tell my heart, my achy, breaky heart, he might blow home and kill his man. Don't tell my heart, my achy, breaky heart. I just don't think you'd understand. And if you tell my heart, my achy, breaky heart, he might blow up and kill this man. Don't tell my heart, my achy, breaky heart. I just don't think you'd understand. And if you tell my heart, my achy, breaky heart, he might rob and kill this man. Ooh.
Unless you want to take a vacation in Arkansas, huh?
And it puts Brace in the finals of our You Be a Star music video contest.
Right. In a couple of weeks, we'll be announcing the winners. Good luck, Brace.
And now we return to As the Maw Turns.
In short swimsuit. Oh, and I wouldn't worry about anyone noticing your figure under all those stripes. Have a nice day. Bobo, you're so sweet to buy me another present, but You know I'm allergic to perfume.
I'm sorry, Mumu. I forgot.
Well, if you two are done making me sick, there's a lot of things to be done around here. Bayonne, did you know that when you get jealous, your crow's feet crinkle up? It's really cute. Well, Beau, it looks like you and my uncomplicated sister are having a good time.
Oh, yeah. We went to Connie's Corn Dogs, the Yarn Barn, Just Hair.
Just Hair, huh? Is that where you flipped out over that sideburn incident and held that shampoo girl hostage with a blow dryer?
What? Where'd you hear that? That's not true. It's not. Get out of here. You're fired.
Oh, yeah? Let's see who gets fired when I call your father, R.D. Buford, and tell him how you're dating a store employee. You know that's against company policy.
You wouldn't dare.
Try.
Put the phone down, Bayonne.
Make me.
Drop it or your kid sister gets...
Mama, don't! Bayonne, save me! Why should I? I never liked you. And neither did my split personality, Raven, by the way. Oh, God, Bayonne! In spite of everything, I'm still your one and only sister. So we know. Does that mean anything to you? Let me think about it a minute.
We will return to As the Mall Turns.
Well, Kevin, we're back on the road again.
This stop marks in Washington, D.C. at this year's Invent America contest, checking out some of the wild inventions.
Washington, D.C. is my favorite place to check out the history of the United States. It's also a perfect place for the Invent America contest, in which kids from kindergarten through eighth grade are honored for their innovative inventions.
So, how exactly does this straw work?
First, you have to put it in the refrigerator.
Right.
And fill it up with beets.
Okay.
The beets help it stay cold.
And then what happens is when you drink the soup, you don't burn your mouth, right? Because
right.
It cools it off on the way up?
Right.
Ingenious. Simple, but ingenious. Okay, William, now tell me about your invention.
All right, well, when you're on vacation and you're sitting for a long time, your legs get uncomfortable, and when you use this, they feel better by creating proper blood circulation.
I can feel it. I can feel the circulation. All right, now this next invention is for you club members at home who spend a little bit too much time playing video games. All right, now, Shelley, tell me about your invention.
Well, you take out your heat vent, and you put it in a home prep cup, and so now you can practice putting in your living room.
That's great. All right. Great for a rainy day.
Being an environmentalist, I was really interested in meeting some young inventors who took their concerns for the environment one step further. Like Jenny's leaf log, a log for the fireplace made from rake leaves that might have been thrown away.
So this is a way to reuse all the leaves that fall onto the lawn.
Right, and you can also use it as a heat source.
That's great. All right. Well, thanks a lot. All right, Hannah, tell me about your invention.
My invention is a pencil that's made out of recycled magazine.
Well, that's great, but how do you sharpen it?
Well, you sharpen it just like a regular pencil, and I found out that the shaving from the pencil can be used to make another pencil.
We've seen so many great inventions already, and we haven't been here that long. I don't know how these kids come up with this stuff. All right, well, this is my buddy Jason, and he was having a lot of trouble finding his marble, so we invented Jason's Poppin' Store. All right, show me how it works, Jason.
Okay.
Oh, that's great. You know, I wish you'd invented that when I was growing up. It would have saved me a lot of time.
This next inventor really wants you to see what it's like to be in her shoes.
You usually only wear your sandals a couple times during the summer, and by next summer they're too small. So you can take it apart, attach a piece in, and then close it up, and it's big enough for you to wear that year.
That's great. So you can have a brand new pair of sandals every year?
Yep.
All right, now, how many links do you think I'd need to make it fit?
A lot.
A lot? Hey, Brittany. All right, tell me about your invention.
Well, it's called a travel table, and you use it in a van so you're not bored, and you can eat, read, and color while you're on trip. So you know.
That's great, and everything on the table is Velcroed down, right?
The day flew by as I checked out as many inventions as possible, but the end of the day came before I knew it. I wish someone would invent a time machine to make days longer.
All right, well, that's it for Invent America. This year, we saw a lot of smart kids with a lot of great inventions. You know, I think I better start mine now if I'm going to have it ready for next year. Catch you later.
And now for the conclusion of As the Mall Turns.
Release the girl. She's highly allergic.
No way, man. She's my ticket out of here. And I want a helicopter and a bucket of buffalo wings for Chicken Eddie's. Yeah, and fries. Burn them.
What's going on here?
Well, you see, sir, she was kidnapped by the evil cosmetologist, Enid Del Vecchio. But before that, she was found on her doorstep under some really mysterious...
Mr. Buford, I'm Bayonne Botnick, head cashier, employee of the month and winner of the Buford Hygiene Award.
Son, give it up. I gotta get to a board meeting in 10 minutes.
No way, Dad. I've got perfume here and I'm not afraid to use it.
If this isn't a bad time, I'd like to discuss with you some of the suggestions I have for the buy one, get one free bikini sale.
Excuse me. Hello, I'm Dr. Mindy Glockenspiel, mall psychiatrist. What seems to be the trouble?
Ever since I was a child, I felt that I haven't gotten the envy I deserve.
Interesting.
I know what you're thinking, Doc. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking my boy has suffered through a life of neglected materialism. You know, what I need to do as a father is to give him a low-paying job and make him work his way up from the bottom of the ladder like I did.
Exactly.
Does this mean the manager position is available?
Son, I'm cutting you off financially and demoting you to janitor.
Janitor? You like me. You really like me.
Oh, Bobo, let's start over.
Are you crazy? If it wasn't for Bayonne's wicked self-centeredness, I wouldn't be janitor today. What do you say, Bayonne? You and me?
If you think I'm going to date a janitor, you've got another thing coming. Oh, and by the way, Moody.
Music Day guest has risen to the top of the charts with her first album called Finally.
And now here's Cece Peniston with her hit song Keep On Walking.
All right.
Come on, y'all, put your hands together. We're here to have a good time today, and I want to see some hand clapping out here. You can just go. Thank you.
Were you surprised by the incredible success of your first album?
Actually, I was. When it happened, I was really surprised. I knew that would happen one day, but exactly when, I really wasn't sure. And then when I heard that finally hit number one on the charts, I was like, oh, really? You know, I was really happy about it.
That's really great that you got it on the first try, and I'm sure there are a lot of kids out there who'd love to be in your shoes. How did you go about, like, breaking into the music business?
Well, actually, what happened was I was singing background vocals for another artist on A&M Records. A producer at the time, his name's Felipe Delgado. He had a record. He was doing an album at the time at Wizard Studios. He said, I need you to do some background vocals. Why don't you come on in? So he gave me the music, had me learn it, and I went and did the background vocals. And that's how everything started.
Now, what advice would you give to younger people about getting into the music industry?
I would tell them that if they have a dream, to follow that dream. Because I think it's always good for everyone to have a star to reach for. I would tell them to do like a lot of talent shows, demo work, things mm-hmm. like that. But also remember to also please get an education, because without education, you know, you can't go anywhere and there's no guarantee in life.
Do you have any certain heroes or people who inspire you? I know I do.
Well, the people I remember listening to when I was younger would be Patti LaBelle, Luther Vandross, Shirley Murdoch, Minnie Riperton. Those are the people I remember listening to.
Now, Finally is a really great song. I was wondering what you think the components of a hit song are.
I would say the components of a hit song would have to be the music, for one, the lyrics, and the vocals. I feel like you have to have three elements. You can't just have one without the other. I feel like if you have all three, then you have a complete song.
That's great. Do you hear yourself on the radio sometimes and think, oh, cool?
Yeah, I still hear myself, and sometimes I still pinch myself and say, is that me? You know, because really everything did happen very quickly.
All right. Well, thank you so much for coming.
Sure.
All right.
Thanks for
coming.
Now it's time to say goodbye to all our company. MIC.
See you real soon.
J-E-Y.
Why?
Because we like you.
M-O-U-S-E.
Who's the leader of the club that's made for you and me? M-I-C-K-E-Y, M-O-U-S-C. Come on and move, the biggest move. MMC is always in the group.
I will.
Get it?
This is
good. Word. MMC. We're gonna rock the house. You know it's prime, the bus is a rhyme, the club is always moving, right on.
Reebok is proud to be the exclusive supplier of athletic footwear to the Mickey Mouse Club.
The UBA Star Contest was conducted and judged by the producers of the Mickey Mouse Club. Winners were chosen based on originality, performance, and execution. The deadline for entries has passed. UBA Star Contest winning entries may have been edited for broadcast.
The Mickey Mouse Club is videotaped before a live audience at the Disney MGM Studios in Lake Buena Vista, Florida.
Hey, check out the new sitcom, Prescott Pratt.
Far up.
And hang with Major Dad star Marissa Ryan, guest day tomorrow on the Totally Better Mickey Mouse Club.